सो हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 247। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड गाइस इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम मोर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द पीआईबी न्यूज व्हिच आर रेलेवेंट फॉर द ईएसआई सेक्शन ऑफ आरबीआई ग्रेड बी एंड नाबार्ड। एंड आई होप गाइस योर प्रिपरेशंस आर गोइंग गुड, जस्ट कीप ऑन रिवाइजिंग व्हाटएवर यू हैव कवर्ड एंड अगर कुछ बचा है तो वी डू नॉट पैनिक, वो भी कवर हो जाएगा। ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन गाइस, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन if you are new here do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon and also you can join this telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions. All right, so let's talk about the very first question. So which of the following center will be the nodal agency for the implementation of India's Arctic policy? So guys, government of India has recently drafted a new Arctic policy. Okay, Arctic policy abhi draft ki gayi thi, so we will discuss about this draft Arctic policy and remember it is a draft, it has not been confirmed by the cabinet, so we will not discuss it in that much detail. Once it will become it will be confirmed by the cabinet, then we will discuss in detail. All right, so let's talk about this news. So the government of India has drafted a new Arctic policy. Aur ye Arctic policy kyun draft ki gayi hai, this policy has the three objectives. Okay, teen objectives hai iske. Number one, टू प्रमोट द साइंटिफिक स्टडी ऑफ आर्कटिक रीजन, आर्कटिक रीजन का जो साइंटिफिक स्टडी है उसको प्रमोट करने के लिए। देन देर इज अ प्लानिंग फॉर मिनरल और ऑयल गैस एक्सप्लोरेशन एंड देन प्रमोशन ऑफ सस्टेनेबल टूरिज्म इन द आर्कटिक रीजन। सो बेसिकली तीन ऑब्जेक्टिव के साथ इस नेशनल आर्कटिक पॉलिसी को ड्राफ्ट किया गया है। नंबर वन इज फॉर द प्रमोटिंग सस्टेनेबल टूरिज्म इन द आर्कटिक रीजन, then for scientific research in the Arctic region, and then for the mineral and natural gas exploration in the Arctic region. All right, and which agency is the implementing agency for this draft policy? This is National Center for Polar and Ocean Research, National Center for Polar and Ocean Research, and it is located in Goa in India. It is located in Goa and it is the nodal agency. It will be the nodal agency for implementation of this policy, which is known as Arctic policy. All right, so therefore guys the correct answer is what, और हमें इसमें अभी इतना ही पढ़ना है। इन फ्यूचर अगर ये पॉलिसी प्रॉपरली फॉर्मुलेट हो जाएगी then we will discuss in detail, अभी फिलहाल हमें इतना ही पढ़ना है। okay, so which of the following center will be the nodal agency? So it's National Center for Polar and Ocean Research which is located in Goa, and remember in Arctic we have research centers like Himadri and we also have IND ARC, and while in the Arctic region we have research stations also, Bharati, and we have Maitri also. All right, so these are some research station in Arctic and the Antarctic regions. Okay, and now let's come to question number 2, which is about India Africa Trade Council. So recently guys, India Africa Trade Council has been inaugurated in Chennai, which is of course the capital of Tamil Nadu. So let's discuss this news, India Africa Trade Council. So as I told you, India Africa Trade Council was inaugurated in Chennai in Tamil Nadu, and this has been inaugurated for developing business relations between India and the African region. Africa regions ki kuch countries aur India ke beech mein business ko badhane ke liye this India Africa Trade Council has been inaugurated in Chennai. And moving ahead, so this council guys will open 13 trade offices in the major metro cities of our country. Hamare desh ke मेजर मेट्रो सिटीज में 13 ट्रेड ऑफिसेस खोले जाएंगे, एंड दिस 13 ट्रेड ऑफिसेस विल हेल्प दोज बिजनेसमैन हु वांट्स टू ट्रेड इन द अफ्रीकन रीजन, जो कि अफ्रीकन रीजन में ट्रेड करना चाहते हैं ये ट्रेड ऑफिसेस उनकी हेल्प करेंगे। ओके, एंड हु हैज बीन अपॉइंटेड एज द डायरेक्टर ऑफ दिस इंडिया अफ्रीका ट्रेड काउंसिल, सो इट मिस्टर बी रामाकृष्णन को इस काउंसिल का डायरेक्टर बनाया गया है। एंड हु इज ही इज द फाउंडर ऑफ कॉर्पोरेट क्लिनिक which is an organization which provides funding to the new companies in our country. Okay, and the important thing that the council will focus in the COMESA region of Africa. Ye COMESA region pe focus karega. Now what is this COMESA region of Africa? So let's talk about this. So guys, COMESA stands for Common Market for Eastern and Southern Africa. Common Market for Eastern and Southern Africa, and it is basically a free trade agreement with within 21 member countries. Okay, 21 member nations का ये free trade agreement है, 21 African countries का. So there are total 21 African countries और उनके बीच का ये क्या है, एक free trade agreement है. And COMESA, remember the full form also, Common Market for Eastern and Southern Africa. It was formed in the year 1994 and its secretariat is located in Lusaka, which is the capital city and of course the largest city of Zambia. And currently, as I told you, there are 21 member nations, and all of them are from Africa. And India, guys, also is a cooperating country. India is also a cooperating country in this COMESA. And jo India ke High Commissioner hai in Lusaka. India's High Commissioner in Lusaka is India's special representative to COMESA. Okay, jo India ke High Commissioner hai in Lusaka is the India's special representatives in COMESA. All right. So now let's come to question number 2 and 3. So question number 2 is what? India-Africa Trade Council was inaugurated in Chennai for building up business relations between India and African region. So who has been appointed as the director of the council? So as I told you, he is the founder of Corporate Clinic. He is Mr. B. Ramakrishnan. Option B, B. Ramakrishnan here is the correct answer. And question number 3 is you have to consider these statements regarding COMESA and you have to identify the correct statement. So 3 statements given hai and you have to identify the correct one. So it was formed in 1995. No, it was not 1995, it was 1994 when it was formed. Its secretariat is located in Nairobi in Kenya. No, that is not in Nairobi, it is in Lusaka, which is in Zambia. Alright. And Nairobi mein we have the headquarter, or you can say the secretariat of United Nations Environment Program, as we all know. And currently it has 19 members. No, there are 21 members, which means all the statements are incorrect here and we have to identify the correct statement. Alright, so therefore, option D, none is correct, will be the correct answer. And now let's move on to question number 4. So you have to consider the following statements regarding India's multimodal logistic park. This should be India's largest. Alright, correct. Mark the correction. India's largest multimodal logistic park that is going to come up in Virochan Nagar, and you have to identify the correct statements. Okay. Ye Virochan Nagar naam ki jagah pe establish ho raha hai, and where is it located? Virochan Nagar, it is in the Ahmedabad district. It is in the Ahmedabad district, and we all know Ahmedabad is in Gujarat. So India's largest multimodal logistic park is going to come up in Virochan Nagar in Ahmedabad district of Gujarat. So let's talk about this. And we all know, guys, India's first multimodal logistic park was recently inaugurated in Jogibopa, and Jogibopa is in Assam. Alright, so let's talk about this. India's largest multimodal logistic park. So India's largest multimodal logistic park, as I told you, is going to come up in Virochan Nagar in Ahmedabad district. And for this, an MOU has been signed between the government of Gujarat and Adani Ports and Special Economic Zones Limited. Gujarat ki sarkar aur Adani ke beech mein ek MOU hua hai for this. And it will be established on approximately 1450 acre area with an expected investment of rupees 50,000 crore. 50,000 crore ka investment ka isme expectation hai, and it is expected that it will create around 25,000 direct and indirect employment opportunities for the Indian youth. Okay, 25,000 direct or indirect employment opportunities ye create karega, and it will be completed, guys, by the 2023, yani ki 3 saal ke andar isko complete karna hai. Okay, so I hope this news is clear and now you can easily answer this question. So you have to find the correct statement regarding India's largest multimodal logistic park. So it will be established in Rajasthan. So no, Virochan Nagar is not in Rajasthan, it's in Gujarat in the Ahmedabad district, which means this statement is incorrect. It has an expected investment of rupees 50,000 crore, absolutely correct, and the target year of completing the project is 2023. This is also correct, guys, which means option C, only 2 and 3 will be the correct answer. Okay, and now let's move on to question number 5, guys, which is based on a government scheme. So let's talk about the question based on government scheme. So you have to identify the scheme after reading this passage. A scheme was launched by the Ministry of Minority Affairs. So in these type of questions, guys, you have to identify the hints which is given in the passage. So ministry given hai, all right to assist minority students by providing them free coaching for various entrance examinations of professional courses and recruitment in government ABNC services. Okay, so the basic objective is given in the under this project. Financial assistance is provided to the minority students who wants to prepare for the entrance examination of technical or professional courses like medical, engineering, law, or you can say GMAT vagera, ye sari cheeze. And other than this, for the recruitment in government A, B and C services ke liye bhi isme coaching di jayegi. Under the scheme, rupees 2500 is provided as the stipend to the minority students. So you have to identify the scheme. So guys, can you identify the scheme? Write down the comments. write down the answer in the comments. Can you identify the scheme? So there are various hints which are given. In fact, the whole scheme is given here. जो कि आपको इस scheme में पढ़ना है वो सब कुछ given है. Ministry is given, the objective is given, and the stipend amount is also given. Okay. So let me tell you the answer here. The correct answer to this question is option C, Naya Savera. So Naya Savera scheme is the scheme from the Ministry of Minority Affairs, under which financial assistance is provided to the minority students for preparing for the entrance examination of technical or professional courses and for the recruitment to the government A, B, and C services. Okay. Under this, ₹2,500 is provided as the stipend to the minority students who is getting free coaching from the institutions. And इसमें basically क्या होता है? The government provides fee to the coaching institutions, which in turn provide free coaching to the minority students. Okay, government क्या करती है? Financial assistance provide कराती है. जो भी coaching की fees होती है, वो institutions को provide करा देता है. And then that institution provides free coaching to the minority students. And correct answer is what? सी नया सवेरा. एंड डोंट कंफ्यूज बिटवीन नया सवेरा एंड नया उड़ान. नई उड़ान, नई उड़ान वॉज द स्कीम फॉर दो स्टूडेंट्स हु हैव क्लियर्ड द प्री एग्जाम्स ऑफ यूपीएससी एसएससी. ओके, यूपीएससी एसएससी या फिर स्टेट पीएससी के अगर प्री एग्जाम निकाल लिए हैं, देन द फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंस इज प्रोवाइडेड थ्रू द नई उड़ान. बट द इनिशियल फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंस इज प्रोवाइडेड थ्रू द नया सवेरा. सो देर इज अ डिफरेंस. ओके, एंड गाइस, दैट्स इट फॉर द सेशन. आई होप ऑल द क्वेश्चंस आर क्लियर. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.